invitation to treat, as if it was an invitation to treat, the opera has the right to accept or to deny offers that come their way. In this case, since it was specified that any who accepted would be qualified as finalists, there seems to be no space for such a consideration of offers before acceptance. On a second note, as Your Excellency mentioned, that reliance on the case of Errington versus Errington must be on the count of continued acceptance and not on the communication of acceptance. As previously mentioned, it is a bilateral case, whereas the rules of acceptance are different in the case of unilateral. It is also mentioned that consideration was not sufficient. However, as addressed in the case of White versus Bluer, it is not a vague acceptance once there is a monetary value in consideration provided in consideration. The ₹1,500 paid was in fact the monetary consideration paid, and therefore it is sufficient and it need not be addressed whether it was adequate, as held in the case of Thomas or Thomas. Also, the counsel for the respondent states that it must be revoked in the same platform. The same platform would have been the storefront where it was advertised in the first place. Therefore, the counsel concludes that in any case it was not an invitation to treat, it was an offer. Consideration was provided, and in any case, revocation was not done in such a timely manner.
Thank you. Respondent may now present Sarif.
Your Excellencies, may it please your court. Counsel will submit the rebuttals based on the rebuttals provided by the claimant. Counsel believes that the claimant submitted three rebuttals, and counsel will still rebut all of the three rebuttals given by the claimant. Since counsel, the claimant counsel kept it very brief to the rebuttals, counsel will adequately try and incorporate all of the rebuttals into her main points. So the first rebuttal that counsel submitted was the fact that this was in fact not a trade hub, but instead an advertisement, and thereby should be considered as such. The reasoning behind why it was not a trade hub, I believe the claimant counsel stated that because the terms in the advertisement stated that anyone who registered would be a finalist was why it needed to be an advertisement and not a trade hub. This was the only reasoning that counsel submitted, and her reasoning was that no, it was an advertisement because the term stated that if you registered, then it would be an advertisement and not a trade hub because the term says so. Now, the respondent counsel would like to rebut this on three levels of analysis. My first level of analysis based on this rebuttal is that Your Honor, we have proved to you exactly why counsel believes that this is a trade puff. Why it is a trade puff is because of the ambiguity of the offer itself, and thereby just because the wording in the advertisement states that if you register at midnight, means you're going to be selected as a finalist, does not automatically qualify for it to be an advertisement. For it to be an offer, there needs to be several considerations that have not been accepted here, right? So because on this ground, we believe that this term stating to register at midnight merely qualified for a trade pub. This was the attempt of a salon to obviously increase their commercial activity here, and it was no way it was an offer. Thereby, the claimant counsel stating that because the salon made such a statement in their advertisement, the salon needs to be bound by such statement is not adequate here and does not stand, because the counsel also did not submit reasons as to why it should stand. And the respondent counsel has told you exactly why it should not stand and why it is a trade pub. Now the claimant's second argumentation was the fact that the consideration submitted here was 1,500, and it is a monetary value, and thereby it should be consideration. Your Honor, the counsel would like to remind you here that this so-called consideration of 1,500 was not in fact consideration. It was payment for a service. right? Consideration is when you have been burdened by something, when you have suffered something to obtain something else, right? But what we believe here is it's not consideration merely, it is payment for a service, right? And thereby cannot be termed consideration, and thereby the claimant's argument that it is consideration here and thereby it has monetary value does not stand, because it is a very obvious service. The respondents, the claimant's third argument was the fact that it was the revocation of the offer was not made on the same platform. But like my co-counsel stated to you, the rules of revocation state that it needs to be on the same platform or a platform better than this. Now, why the respondent is stating that Facebook was in fact a better platform than the window of the shop was that the revocation of the offer was made at 12 a.m. Was made at 12 a.m. on Facebook. It did not make any sense to post the notice at 12 a.m. on the shop window. We would not have reached any audience, whereas posting that notice at 12 a.m. on Facebook would have reached the audience that beauty salon wanted to reach, particularly because if people were submitting these requirements in the offer, then they would have seen it at the time that the offer was revoked, right? So that is why we're saying it is a better platform, because it would have reached the same audience and a better audience, because that even revoking the offer was not going to be seen at 12 a.m. on the shop window. Thereby, submitting the revocation on Facebook was in fact a better mode, because it would have reached a better audience, specifically because the offer was revoked at that period of time, which was 12 a.m., which is at midnight. Right. Now, are there further arguments that the respondent...
Counsel, your time is up.
Okay. Thereby, counsel believes that we have successfully rebutted the points brought up by the claimant. Counsel rests.
Thank you. We thank both the teams. And